My name is Stephanie, and I work at the Albert George Branch Library. Do you enjoy DIY projects? Are you interested in natural and sustainable living? Would you like to save money by making, reusing, and repairing things yourself? The library is a great place to find information on all these topics, and today I want to highlight three books that you may want to check out. Simply Living Well by Julia Watkins is full of tips, how-tos, and recipes for minimizing waste around the home. Watkins says on the first page that zero waste is a process, not an event. So the reader is encouraged to adopt the practices that best fit their lifestyle, one small change at a time. She discusses ways to avoid plastic and excess packaging in the kitchen, how to make natural cleaning solutions and homemade toiletries, how to start composting, and more. The pictures are gorgeous, and it's evident that the author really knows what she's talking about. I followed her instructions to make fermented radishes. Mine aren't as pretty as hers, but the instructions were easy to follow, and they turned out exactly like she said they would. Cottagecore refers to an aesthetic and lifestyle that celebrates simplicity, the outdoors, and an idealized pastoral life. The Little Book of Cottagecore by Emily Kent is all about slowing down, unplugging, and making something from scratch just for the joy of it. Each chapter is a brief introduction to a hobby, such as gardening, baking, quilting, and candle making. A chapter per topic might not seem like a lot, but that's what makes this book a great choice if you're interested in trying something new but aren't quite sure where to start. In fact, the author specifically says not to start beekeeping until you've done more research. For everything else, though, she discusses materials and basic techniques, then provides instructions for a beginner-level project. I followed the cross-stitch pattern in the book. It's a cute design and came together quickly. It reminded me how much I enjoy cross-stitch. Storey's Curious Compendium of Practical and Obscure Skills is broader in scope and a little more adventurous than the previous two books. It's fully illustrated 214 articles, cover topics ranging from cooking and repair to homesteading and survival. Some of the projects involving gardening, animals, and building might not be doable if you're living in an apartment or renting. However, there are still plenty of other useful recipes, crafts, and everyday skills that anyone can try. Some of the articles would make great art or science projects for kids. I followed the tutorial to bake bread in a flower pot. It made a delicious loaf full of seeds, veggies, and cheese. I'm going to use this recipe again. If you're interested in any of these titles, visit your local library or use the online catalog to check availability and place a hold. I hope you have a great time learning new skills and making something from scratch. Thank you for joining me today.